here on the Bossman Show. New head coach of UNLV, the Runnin' Rebels, out of the Mountain West Conference, Coach Kevin Kruger. Coach, how you doing, man? Good to talk to you.
Hey, good. How's it doing? How's it going over there? Thanks for having me on.
It's going good, Coach. I know you probably had some roots in Atlanta from your time when your dad was here with the Hawks, man. You graduated from high school here. So how do you feel about seeing the Hawks play the Knicks, man, and get to the second round of playoffs, man?
No, it was good. It was, there's a little added intrigue for us with Trey being there, of course, you know, having worked with Trey at Oklahoma. But, no, you mentioned it, Walton High School grad out in Marietta, and played for the Georgia Stars with Norm Parker, and, you know, a lot of good memories and a lot of good friends from that time.
Now, Coach Kruger, let me ask you this about Trey Young. When you had him at Oklahoma, did you think he'd be as good as he is right now with the Hawks right now?
I mean, we knew he always was an electric player. You know, he did it in college. I think some of the questions, you know, that were asked about him with his size and his weight, but what he's shown is that speed kills. And his ability to change pace, change direction, pull up and shoot it at any time, really just keeps defenders off balance. And he can draw a foul at any time. And you know, I think that ability, that skill set, that the skill he has with either hand, just makes him so dynamic. I mean, what do? You know, you can't trap him. He's too fast. He can find too many people. You try to get too physical with him, he draws fouls. You back up off him or try to play flat, then he can see the whole floor. And, you know, you really, I if I had an answer, I'd probably be coaching in the NBA against him, but I don't. And we were very, very happy with our time with him in Oklahoma. He was fun to watch, and he's fun to watch now. I mean, that was an impressive series, and Trey's not going to back down from anything. So, you know, that game, that loss against New York was probably the best thing that could have happened for them in Atlanta, just to kind of get him going and make sure it didn't happen again.
Most definitely. Now, Coach, I'm asking about yourself, man. Getting the head coaching job at UNLV, a classic school there out there in the Mountain West Conference, a lot of history out there, man. How's it feel having this job out here, leading this program back to his prominence once more?
No, it's an honor. It really is. You know, I had the opportunity to play for UNLV for my graduate transfer year. So, you know, this is home for me. I'm an alum here. It's just got an extra level of special to it. So, going in every day, just couldn't be more excited and happier. You know, life's pretty good right now. You know, we got a young family and we love the city. We love the people that we're around. And we're going to try even that much harder to make it work so we don't have to go anywhere.
And how cool is that an administration that has your back from day one? You align, the symmetry's there. Because, you know, without that, you can't really win. A lot of people don't understand this. You win with administrations, more so than X and O's, having the support, the resources, all that goes hand in hand to winning on the court every night when fans come out and cheer for you.
No, absolutely. I mean, the resources and the support here at UNLV are as good as anywhere. You know, we've got an unbelievable practice facility, 2 full-length courts, you know, weights, training room, all right there in the same location, connected to the Thomas and Mack where we play our home games. The living right here, you know, is you know, second to none. So we've got it all right here at such a high level too. You know, we didn't have to compromise anything there throughout the years in terms of location or size of the building or what have you. Because, I mean, having those 2 full-length courts, you know, there's never any time you walk into the gym, you know, there's mostly a hoop where you can hop on with somebody so it's not too crowded and get shots up and get work in. So, you know, no, but as you mentioned, the resources and the support here and the support in the community, you know, as you mentioned with a historic program like UNLV, really, really couldn't be luckier to have this as the first opportunity.
And Las Vegas is growing. Like, you know, the Raiders now with the stadium they got, you know, the hockey team and probably in the future NBA team probably in the future is coming to Las Vegas. So Las Vegas is growing. It's booming. And not to mention NBA Summer League's coming in August. So that's also made Vegas booming as well. So Las Vegas, to me, Coach, it's booming. A lot of things going on out there. It's a great place to come out and live, work, and play ball.
No, exactly. As you mentioned, I mean, Vegas is growing like a weed. And it's just that with the sports teams coming, you know, might add baseball and basketball here soon. You got the Raiders, you got the Golden Knights, you got the college atmosphere. Then, of course, you have the entertainment and the nightlife of the Strip. So there's really nothing that Vegas doesn't offer in terms of entertainment. But, yeah, I mean, it's growing. The numbers are growing up, from what the news says, at a, you know, historic rates, and have been for a few years. And the city keeps growing out through Summerlin, you know, down through Henderson, out to Boulder City. So, you know, it's a great time to be in Vegas. There's a lot of excitement, a lot of growth, a lot of energy. And like, as you mentioned, support for kind of things to keep the city going.
And coach, looking at your players this summer, they can be on campus and work out with you and being a first year head coach when they implement your system. How key is to have guys on campus, being able to work them out, individual drills, also some team drills, watching film with those guys, evaluating what you have before October shows up here real soon?
No, it's vital. It's vital to have those guys here, to have them around each other as much as what we're going to put in from a staff, just to have the guys interacting with each other daily, you know, getting that extra time in the gym together, having those meals together, playing video games, you know, kind of figuring each other out and getting around each other so they can develop that bond and that connection. So when they get out on the court, there's a relationship that's built there. And those are always the ones that, you know, work best. You know, when you love the guys you're fighting with, you know, the teams are usually better.
And how's that been relationship for you guys, a coach? You know, you're a new coach, and a new good coach comes in. There's always some attrition and having to build trust with guys. How's that been for you so far since you took this over this job here?
It's been good. You know, we've had a lot of transfers, so we do have a new team kind of from last year. But a lot of the transfers that came in were guys that we had either recruited in high school or coached at some point, or, you know, we played against. So there is a level of familiarity there. But as you mentioned, yeah, I mean, there's no shortcut for building that trust and building that relationship other than just spending time with each other.
Most definitely, because I feel like if a guy trusts and believes in you, he'll play harder for you. You know, mm-hmm. I know when I played, if I believed in the guy, trusted the coach, you know, I'm going to play harder for the guy. If I didn't think the guy was worth a quarter, I might not dive on the floor for that loose ball. I might get a burner for that, you know. So that's so key for guys to have that trust with the coach, because really for me, coach, it's a 40-year relationship. No, the 4 years you're there, one thing, two or three years you're there, but you want a relationship 40 years, coming to weddings and seeing kids grow older, be successful in life. Because once the ball stops, you got to do something beyond the ball. So that's what absolutely really is key for those kind of connections. That's real connections for life.
No, absolutely. I think, as you mentioned, you know, going to weddings, having them bring their kids by and their families by in the future to watch a game where, you know, where their dads used to play, and, you know, just hearing those stories from their parents. I mean, that's where it's really fun. I mean, of course, you know, you enjoy watching, you know, the Trae Youngs and the Buddy Hields, you know, and them go on and play in the NBA. And that's exciting to watch on TV. But even, you know, 10 years from now, 15 years from now, you know, to have those guys come back and be around them and see their families and how their lives have gone since then, non-basketball is where it's really fun.
And how is for you, coach, the transfer portal change how you get players now? Because now you can talk to the guys directly now without having to go through intermediate like the AAU coach or JUCO guy. You can talk to them right away. So how's that going to change recruiting for you guys going forward? Also, when you've been a national brand anyway, you can get guys from all over the country come to UNLV because it's a national brand.
Yeah, I think there's a little bit of a combination of both, as you mentioned. You know, COVID also changed that a little bit because we weren't able to have visits, which that's why we really relied on the relationships we had built through the recruiting process. You know, we have Donovan Williams, for example, who we recruited when I was at Oklahoma. And so we knew him a little bit as a person, as a kid. So it wasn't just completely foreign because you didn't get that visit. You didn't get to sit down at a table and look, you know, across the table from a family eye to eye and kind of see, you know, what's true, what's not, what, you know, where your antenna go up or what you, how you trust them or anything like that to build that relationship going forward. But, you know, the portal to us is, you know, like the one and done rule or the one and done rule when that was implemented, how social media has kind of changed the college game of basketball and the NBA, of course, too. But, you know, you almost see the portal kind of, we see the portal something like that, where you can put resistance up to it if you want, you know, like with the one and done, people didn't like it. Coaches refused to kind of buy into it. Then with the social media, you know, they encourage guys, you know, stay off it. You know, and until eventually it just took over. And then now with the portal, I think if you're resistant to it, I think you're behind. And that's why we have taken the approach that this is just the way the game's going to be, at least for the next handful of years. So we want to embrace it and try to use it to our advantage as much as possible. And hopefully we're out ahead of it. And instead of kind of looking back saying we wish.
Most definitely. And the Mountain West is a tough league, Coach, from top to bottom, man. There's no easy nights. Tell us about the league, man. So how has it grown since you was in that league when you played out there?
Yeah, I mean, the Mountain West is a very tough, respected league. You know you're going to get be in a fight when you play a Mountain West team, and especially, you know, when conference rolls around. There was a little realignment since I played. You know, when I played, BYU was probably our main kind of rival there for a couple years, and then they obviously went West Coast Conference and independent for football. But, you know, having, you know, the additions of Reno, which is also our – you know, are probably our main rival now and always has been, but we didn't play them twice. So now we get to play them twice, but you know, it's a very good league. I mean, San Diego State's definitely been carried the flag of the league for a handful of years. So they're the team to beat. And I think everybody knows it and nobody's been able to do it for a while. You know, we've had some years, but what Coach Fisher and Coach Dutcher have done out there is amazing. And we want to build something like that. You know, we want to build something with a foundation where when kids come in, you know, they fall in line with that culture and that way of life and that way of basketball, and the winning just continues.
And I feel like, you know, I think some kids, you know, you don't stand. If you don't go Power 5, the Mountain West, the MAC, the A-10, the CAA, a good conference to go play in, because guess what? As you and I know, both of them, Coach, if you can play, they'll find you. The NBA will come looking for you. And then they'll find you overseas if you can play. So I feel like a lot of kids need to realize, hey, let me go to maybe a non-Power 5 school. It's a good mid-major conference school and really show my skills. And look like a Ja Morant or McCollum or Dame Lillard and look where they're at now.
No, absolutely. I think, you know, what gets lost so many times is just that Power 5, that brand name of the Power 5, you know. And as you mentioned, you know, playing, you got to play, You know, like you said, they'll find you, but you also have to play to be found. And, you know, like we talked about earlier, the resources and the interest here. I mean, we charter our flights here at UNLV and we've got the facilities and the interest of any Power 5. And, a lot of times just kind of that word Power 5 gets thrown around as if there's a, you know, the life's just so much better maybe just because of the conference they're in or where they're at. But, you know, with a city like Vegas and a respected conference like the Mountain West, we know that we're in a good place.
Most definitely. Let me ask you this, to Atlanta here. What's your favorite spot to eat here in Atlanta?
Well, it's not there anymore, but there used to be a place right off Roswell Road in Marietta, Miss Winner's Chicken.
Oh yes, I missed them. Those wings were good. I love miss them.
And the gallon. We would always, me and my buddies would always get the gallon of sweet tea.
Yes. I missed them dearly. I do. I remember that because I'm around your age. So I definitely remember Mrs. Winters. I definitely remember that for sure.
On the way to school, on the way to Walton from where we lived, we would grab Miss Winters or Chick-fil-A every morning.
Yes, indeed. And last one I got for you is, man, what was your favorite memory coming to an Atlanta Hawks game when you was here with your dad was coaching, or just in general? What's your favorite moment coming to them to Hawks games?
Well, unfortunately, when my dad was there, you know, they kind of were building. And he was let go like a quarter of the way into his third year. I wish he would have been able to get that third year to see where it would have gone. But, I mean, life's worked out well for everybody since then. But either way, you know, the one thing that was always really interesting growing up in college towns, when we got to Atlanta, the star power that went to the games, you know, with like Ludacris and, you know, like the rappers from the Atlanta area, you know, Outkast that would be at the games and you know, the actors that lived in that area. That was something I always remembered. You know, Phillips Arena was, you know, the fan support wasn't great at the time, but you always knew you were going to see somebody famous. And being a high school kid, that was pretty cool.
Oh, yes. Phillips Arena was always good. I remember going to the old Omni when I was a kid, you know, because I actually grew up in Vine City. So I didn't grow up that far away from the arena. So, like, you know, for me, you know, my dad would save up some money. We go play at the Omni. I'm like, that was my thing. Go watch them play at the Dome. So, being in the business, I get to go to Hawks games all the time. And I'm like, I'm living a dream, you know.
Yeah, no kidding.
It's my childhood team. But you're right, man. Phillips Arena, man, you can always see somebody famous. You don't even care who can be a random guy. Since it's the Kings or whoever.
Yeah.
You'll see somebody famous at the Hawks game. And I'm like, man, I love it. That's what's the best thing about our city, man. It's always somebody out there going to come to our games and watch it and love
now,
it.
Now with a star like Trae Young, it's just going to keep going.
Yeah, it's funny. Look over there. You see Cardi B. You see 2 Chainz. You see Usher. You see Tripper Jones. You see all Julio Jonesville for now. you see all those guys across the world. They were mad. The Hawks said, even in the years we were tanking, we still had all the people at the games. So, yeah, it's a great thing, man. But, yeah, Coach, hopefully you come play and play Georgia Tech. Hopefully Josh will play you.
Yeah, that'd be great. That'd be great to get back to Atlanta for a little bit.
Yes, sir. Coach, you be safe and talk to you real soon. Best luck to you, man. I'm glad you got the job. Hopefully doing this with you down the road here in August, maybe in September as well.
All right. Thank you. Anytime. You let me know.
Will do, Coach. Thanks so much, brother.
All right. Have a good one.
You too now.